Hello, I'm Chen Zhihao with the Xinhua News Agency. China is a civilization with a history of 5,000 years, preserving their rich cultural heritage both above and below the ground. With the help of digital technology, now we can get close to them and experience the profound depth of traditional culture. Today, I'm in Jinzhong City, North China, Shanxi Province. Recently, the Shanxi Jinzhiyuan Fresco Art Museum opened here. The museum, with its collection of exquisite ancient mural replicas from Shanxi, showcased the origins of ancient Chinese murals. Inside this museum, the largest existing ancient figure painting in China, the Yongle Palace Chaoyuan Tu, has been replicated in its entirety. Let's get close to it and feel the charm of this great painting. In order to understand the murals more clearly, we are honored to have Ms. Guo, the guide of Shanxi Jinzhiyuan Fresco Art Museum, to introduce them to us. 您好, 郭老师.
您好.
Could you give us an overall introduction of this 朝元图? 您能给我们简单介绍一下这个朝元图吗?
好的。 讲到朝元图,必须得从中国道教开始讲起。 中国道教认为宇宙为一元气, 一元气化为三气, 三气又形成三清净，即为太清、玉清和上清，也就是我们之后所讲究到的三清，分别是元始天尊、道德天尊以及灵宝天尊。三清之尊为皆以唐宋以来所形成的，以元始天尊为中心。
Okay, when it comes to Chaoyuan Tu, we must start with Taoism, a Chinese local religion. Taoism believes that the beginning of the universe is a primordial qi. It's also called primordial air, which is divided into three parts, xuan, yuan, and shi, forming three realms of purity, jade pure, upper pure, and supreme pure. Jade pure is the primordial heavenly sovereign, supreme and unparalleled. Upper pure is the limbo heavenly sovereign. Supreme pure is the Daode heavenly sovereign. Since the time of the Song Dynasty, the three pure ones have centered on the primordial heavenly sovereign.
朝元图顾名思义就是众神朝拜元始天尊的宏大场面了。您现在所看到的就是永乐宫三清殿内的壁画，它也是全国重点文物保护单位，创作于元代，距今已经有近700年的历史了。 它是堪比欧洲文艺复兴时期意大利壁画名妓媲美而又创作时间早200年的艺术珍品，是中国古代最大的人物画。朝元图
is a spectacular scene of all gods worshipping the primordial heavenly sovereign. It is a famous mural in the Three Pure Hall of Yongle Palace, a national key cultural relics protection unit. It was completed in the Yuan Dynasty and has a history of about 700 years. It is an artistic treasure comparable to the famous Italian murals of the European Renaissance period, but it was created 200 years earlier. It is currently the largest figure painting in ancient China.
整幅壁画一共有近300尊神仙，以八位主神为中心，画面平均高度约4.4米，总长约100米，总面积超过400平方米。 八位主神像身高近3米，身形最小的玉女也在1.9米以上，超过了真人的高度。人物前后排列达4层之多，都随着自己的领班共同拱卫三清，井然有序。The
entirely painting has nearly 300 gods and immortals, centered on 8 main gods. Total length of the painting is about 100 meters, and the total area exceeds 400 square meters. The 8 main gods are nearly 3 meters tall, and the smallest figure, Jade Girl, is also over 1.9 meters, exceeding the height of a real person. The characters are arranged in up to 4 layers, all following their own leaders, jointly guarding the three pillars in an orderly manner.
Okay, Ms. Guo, we would like to know that what the characters are. Specifically, can you introduce some of them to us?
您能给我们介绍一些这上面的神仙吗?
然可以啦。您现在所看到的就是玉皇大帝，作为天地之间的主神，他能够受到众神去崇拜。而您后面所看到的这一尊是后土娘娘，也就是我们平常生活当中所说到的皇天后土。后土作为大地之母，在汉武帝时期其实就已经受众人去朝拜，包括汉武帝也曾经到达山西万荣后土祠当中去进行朝拜，体现的中国人对土地的一种崇拜了。
OK, let's first look at the Jade Emperor. It's this figure. And he is revered as the main god of heaven and earth. And this is goddess the Houtu, who gives birth to all things, rules all nations and people, and is known as the mother of heaven and earth. Emperors, queens, and officials all worship her. The respect for Houtu appeared in the Han Dynasty. Emperor Wu of Han once worshipped the goddess Houtu at the Houtu Temple in Wanrong County, North China Shanxi Province, reflecting the Chinese people's worship of the land. I know that the Taoism pays great attention to the celestial phenomena. Are there any gods related to it in this painting? 这里面有没有关于一些天象的神呢？
啊，有的。我首先给您介绍一下七曜星君。您现在所看到的是日、月、金、木、水、火、土。这是我们的七曜了。首先手执护板，头上冠饰分别是日月的，就是日月星君了。
OK, let me introduce you to the seven luminaries: the Sun, Moon, Mercury, Venus, Mars, Jupiter and Saturn, collectively known as the seven luminaries. The Sun and Moon star lords, holding their scepters in worship, are symbolized by a golden sun and white moon on their crowns.
在日月星君的背后是其他五星的形象。您首先看到的头戴凤冠、怀抱琵琶的这一位为金星，而臣女相右手持笔的这位为水星，手中有果盘的这一位为文官形象的为木星，而这一边手执龙头拐而且手上有官印的这位就是我们的土星。火星就是后面这一位呈现武将形式的形象了。
The five stars behind them each have their own characteristics. Venus, a female figure, wearing a phoenix crown, holding a pipa, ancient instrument. Mercury, also a female, holding a pen in her right hand, with a monkey decorated on her flown crown, has clearly eyebrows and eyes, and a graceful posture. Mars, a military general, holding weapons with a donkey head on his forehead. Saturn, an old man,holding a gold seal in his left hand and a dragon-headed cane in his right hand. Jupiter, a civil official, holding a fruit plate with both hands.
中国最早采用的是七曜为一周的历法，一直到现在日本和朝鲜半岛还保存有这样子的历法观念，但现今的话就变成了从周日到周一的这样一种历法形式了。
Okay, in ancient times, China used the name of those officials to name every day of a week. And until now, the Japan and North Korea and South Korea are still use the name of those officials to name every day in the week.
这里含有二十八星宿，二十八星宿也是道教所崇拜的星宿神，他们的帽饰上面各以一种动物作为象征，有蛟、龙、鹤、兔。狐、虎、豹、狼、狗、鸡、猴、猿、羊、马、鹿、蛇、蝇、牛、符、鼠、燕、猪等。古代人民用星宿的位置变化来辨别方向，这在古代天文史上占有非常重要的地位。后来经专家多番研究，认为二十八星宿的运行对各个方位具有一定的影响力，所以在古代的占星术中演变为预测吉凶祸福，以作择日催吉避凶之用。
There are also the 28 constellations, important gods worshipped in Taoism. Each constellation is symbolized by an animal: dragon, rabbit, fox, tiger, leopard, wolf, dog, and so on.Ancient people used the position changes of the constellations to identify the directions, which played a very important role in ancient astronomical history. Later, it was believed that the movement of the 28 constellations had a certain influence on each direction. So Chinese ancient people predict good and bad luck for choosing a day to promote good luck and avoid bad luck in ancient astrology. China has the concept of the 12 zodiac signs, which should have a lot to do with the Taoism. I wonder if we can see it in this painting. 中国有那个十二生肖的文化，在这里面有体现吗？
有的，在这边我们可以看到有十二元神，这边是子鼠、丑牛、寅虎、卯兔、辰龙、巳蛇、午马、未羊、申猴、酉鸡、戌狗、亥猪，他们貌似上面有一个圆圈，所代表着他们的自己的生肖动物了。
These are the 12 primordial gods, also known as the 12 zodiac signs, representing the 12 earthly branches. Each with an animal image of the 12 zodiac signs, rat, ox, tiger, rabbit, dragon, snake, horse, sheep, monkey, chicken, dog, and pig.
现在您所看到的玉皇大帝身后的是扶桑大帝。扶桑大帝他是统领山川的，在他身后可以看到手持护板、身穿地装的这五位形象，就是五岳，分别是东岳泰山、西岳华山、北岳衡山、南岳衡山、中岳嵩山，以及后面您所看到的四堵，分别是黄河、长江、淮水以及济水。
Yes, look at the god of five peaks and four rivers. The Jade Emperor is followed by the Fu Sun Emperor, who commands the mountains and the rivers, and his five peaks, Mount Tai, Mount Hua, Mount Hem, and another Mount Hem, and Mount Song, all male figures dressed in imperial attire, holding jade specters with a majestic demeanor. The four rivers are the Yangtze River, the Yellow River,the Huai River and the Ji River, all male, three old and one young, dressed in simple elegance. This reflects the ancient people's worship of nature and awe of destiny.
这边您所看到的三位神仙分别是福星、禄星以及寿星。手中拿拂尘的这一位就是福星啦。中国春节马上就要到了，我们都会在门口贴福字。那就是希望到福的意思，而这边所看到的是禄星，这边大脑门的这位就是寿星了。
Okay, we can see in the middle of this painting, there are three interesting gods. They are called the god of happiness, the god of wealth, and the god of longevity. And the New Year is coming, that Chinese, they are all popular, becoming more popular among Chinese people, because they symbolize all the good things in the future life.
您再看这位六目老翁，相传为创造文字的仓颉，在仓颉的上部，我们在这个位置当中可以看到一位儒雅的书生形象，这一位就是孔子。全真教主张佛、道、儒三教合一，那老子的形象也代表了中国传统文化当中和合的这样一种理念了。
Look at this six-eyed old man.Should be Cang Jie, who is said to be the god who invented Chinese character. Above Cang Jie, an old man wearing a plain robe, who is Confucius. The Taoism advocates the unity of different religions, so it also includes the ancestor of Confucianism, Confucius, in the ranks of immortals, reflecting the concept of harmony in excellent traditional Chinese culture. The entire painting here appears splendidly magnificent.And looks very beautiful. Could you give us a detailed introduction to its artistic features?
你能给我们介绍一下这个壁画里的一些艺术的价值体现在哪儿吗？
当然，画工在近400多平方米的墙面上，采用了传统的对称形式，描绘了近300位神祇朝拜的宏大场面。可以说主次分明，而且您可以仔细观察，在画面当中的人物男女老幼。壮弱肥瘦当中的话不仅主次分明，而且人物当中有文有武，可以说是疏密有致，主次分明，在变化当中求得了统一，而在多样当中又求得了和谐，也体现了画工非常高超the 构图能力了。
Okay, at first, in terms of the composition, the painter has drawn The worship procession of nearly 300 deities on a world surface of more than 400 square meters. Using the traditional symmetrical ceremonial form, the painting is majestic with clear primary and secondary elements. The characters in the painting, men and women, old and young, strong and weak, fat and thin, are appropriately dynamic and aesthetic and well-spaced. They achieve unity in change and harmony in diversity, demonstrating superb compositional skills.
壁画最大的成功在于人物形象的刻画，数以百计的人物，不同的人物形象不同的服饰，无一雷同，各有特征，体现的是不同气质、不同阶层以及不同情思的各种人物，不同的鲜明特征以及人物的个性特征。
The greatest success of the mural lies in the depiction of characters. Hundreds of characters, each with different costumes and expressions, each with their own characteristics, show various characters from different classes, experiences, temperaments, and emotions in reality. They are distinctive and thought-provoking.
在颜料上运用的是纯天然矿物质颜料，在人物的衣冠、衣襟、胸颅处采用了沥粉贴金技艺，既可以使壁画立体突出、富丽堂皇，也可以让壁画经久不衰。Second,
in terms of the pigments, the pure natural mineral pigments are used. The technique of applying gold powder is used in the crowns, collars, armor, and incense burners of the characters, presenting a three-dimensional, splendid artistic effect and making the color of the mural long-standing.
在线描造型上，你来看南极长生大地冕旒上飘下来的这缕冠带，线条沉着有力，流畅飘逸，为朝元图当中最长、最精彩的一笔。 显示了三清殿壁画吴代当风的高超线描造型技法，朝元图充分展现了中国传统线描的高度成就，红剑圆魂，沉着有力，奠定了中国古代美术史上线描艺术成就的一座丰碑。Third,
in terms of the light drawing, the tassel hanging down from the crowns of the Antarctic Emperor. The limes are calm and powerful, smooth and elegant. It is the longest and the most exciting tassel in the Chaoyuan Tu, showing the superb line drawing technique. Chaoyuan Tu fully demonstrates the high achievements of traditional Chinese line drawing, strong and round, calm and powerful, establishing a monument to the achievements of line drawing art in ancient Chinese art history. There are not only interesting stories in the mural itself also has a legendary story. I heard that because of some reasons that in the past, the whole mural has a relocation operation. To learn more about this, so today we have invited Mr. Gao, the guide of the Shanxi Jin Zhiyuan Fresco Art Museum, to introduce us to the stories. 你好, 高先生。
你好,
能给我们介绍一下当时这个壁画搬迁的经历吗?
可以，因为这个壁画呢是依附在那个元代古建筑永乐宫三清殿的这个墙壁上。那二十世纪五十年代的时候，因为这个黄河三门峡水库的修建，那所以说这个永乐宫也处于这个工程淹没区，所以说为了保护这一文化历史文化遗产呢，国务院也下令就是开始整体原模原样的原貌去给它整体搬迁。那从 1959年开始搬迁到终止于1966年，整体历史有8年时间，从整体上搬迁了有20多公里，因此呢，永乐宫这个开创了历史上这个大型壁画及古代建筑这个遗址搬迁保护的一个先河。
Because the mural is attached to the wall of Yongle Palace, a Yuan Dynasty ancient building. In the 1950s, when the Sanmenxia Reservoir on the Yellow River began to be built, Yongle Town, where the Yongle Palace is located, was in the inundation area of the project. In order to protect this precious historical and cultural heritage, the State Council decided to relocate Yongle Palace in its original form. The relocation work began in 1959 and ended in 1966. It took 8 years and moved more than 20 kilometers from the original site. Therefore, Yongle Palace pioneered the protection of large-scale ancient buildings and murals in China. I'm really astounded by the resolution and wisdoms. And Mr. Gao, thank you for your introduction. Thank you. Today, through our visit to the Yongle Palace's Chaoyuan Tu, we have learned the superb painting skills of ancients and also the profound connotations of Taoism. And we also learned the heroic efforts of New China to protect the cultural relics. By visiting those ancient relics, we can learn more about Chinese civilizations deeply. And as you continue to unlock these treasures, you will surely fall in love with this place. I'm in Shanxi Province, China. I welcome all foreign friends to come here to explore the original appearance of China. That's all for today's live. Thanks for your watching and see you next time.